सर सर बिग बॉसों से सम्मानित हो जाए और क्या चाहिए सर।
हाँ
सर
तेरा 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 कल परसों सुना दिलीप मैंने पूरा वीडियो।
सर
हाँ तेरे
उसमें
को
पता है इस बार क्या हुआ?
वीडियो में इश्यू आ रहे थे तेरे।
सर पता है क्या हुआ? इन्होंने पीआरपी का, जो आई वाज अवेयर, बायोफिलर का,
अब
और उन्होंने क्या सर इटलीगो में भी रखा था, एंड दैट आई वाज नॉट कम्युनिकेटेड। एंड वो मैं मेरे बच्चे को दिखा रहा था कि देख ये चीजें ये करना है, तो सर
भाई
पता लगा कि मेरा विटिलिगो भी है। 1:30 बजे पता लगा, वो 3 बजे बोला फिर।
डॉक्टर
चल
दिलीप,
शुरू हो रहा
डॉक्टर
है
दिलीप,
सर।
डॉक्टर दिलीप, वेल वेलकम टू दिस पीजीनार, आवर इवनिंग मीटिंग, डिजिटल सेमिनार
थैंक यू
ऑर्गेनाइज्ड बाय
सर।
रिपब्लिक कॉलेज डर्मेटोलॉजिकल कंसोर्शियम ऑफ इंडिया। एंड टुडे वी आर लकी टू हैव डॉक्टर दिलीप पिछावा विद अस। एंड डॉक्टर दिलीप पिछावा, प्लीज एक्सेप्ट आवर वर्चुअल बुके। एंड यह जोधपुरी टर्बन इज फ्रॉम योर जोधपुर साइड ओनली। एंड
सर सर जोरदार लगा दिए।
यू आर लकी टू बी इंट्रोड्यूस बाय आवर एक्स प्रिंसिपल डॉक्टर यूएस अग्रवाल, हु विल बी इंट्रोड्यूसिंग यू।
यस सर गुड इवनिंग एवरीबॉडी। इट इज माय प्रिविलेज टू इंट्रोड्यूस डॉक्टर दिलीप कच्छावा। ही इज अ वेल नोन फिगर इन नेशनली एंड इंटरनेशनली बाय हिज मेनी टेक्निक्स व्हिच हैज इनो ही हैज इनोवेटिवली इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इन द डर्मेटो सर्जरी। एंड वी आर वेरी प्राउड दैट ही इज आवर मेंबर ऑफ आवर ब्रांच। डॉक्टर दिलीप कच्छावा इज एमडी स्किन एंड बीडी, डब्ल्यूएचओ फेलो एंड डिप्लोमा इन एसटीडी एंड एड्स बैंकॉक। एट प्रेजेंट ही सीनियर प्रोफेसर एंड हेड ऑफ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ द डर्मेटोलॉजी बेनिग्नोज एंड लेप्रोसी एट डॉक्टर एस एन मेडिकल कॉलेज जोधपुर। ही हैज मोर देन 60 पेपर्स टू हिज क्रेडिट व्हिच ही हैज पब्लिश्ड इन मेनी नेशनल एंड इंटरनेशनल जर्नल्स and has presented at least more than 100 guest lectures at various conferences, seminars, workshops on vitiligo and dermatology. Surgery. His main field of working is vitiligo and vitiligo surgery. And he has many awards to his credit, including ITMP mentorship by American Society of Dermatosurgery, Ellen Sinner Award by IDBS 2011, WHO Fellow Award 2005, International Pigment Cell Conference 2005 Award, Reston, USA 2005, Asian Pigment Cell Research Society Award 2005, Diploma in STI AIDS, Asian College of Sexual Education, Bangkok, International Society of Dermatology, New York, USA 2004. So it is sense to speak of his wide travel and widely acknowledged work which he has done, especially the Jodhpur technique which he has introduced in the vitiligo surgery. And as I have previously told you, his main interest is in the vitiligo surgery, dermatosurgery, and PRP. Or of course, he's a very good clinical dermatologist also. So, welcome, Dr. Kachhawa, and today he will be enlightening us on PRP.
Dr. Dilip, please present a bouquet, this virtual felicitation to Dr. Dilip Pichawa. Dr. Lalit.
Dr. Dilip, it's my pleasure and honor to felicitate you. Dr. Dilip is a very good friend of mine, and we have been in contact with each other for almost 3 decades or more. And I have seen him growing his stature from national to international figure. And it's really a proud moment for me to present to you this beautiful presentation. Kindly accepted from on behalf of the DCI and PGNA.
Thank you, sir. What a student will feel when the mentors like Dinesh sir and Uma Shankar ji has introduced me. इससे अच्छा कोई achievement नहीं होता sir. This is my privilege कि आप लोगों ने इतना बड़ा अच्छे शब्द बोले sir. Thank you very much for your kind words. And now we'll be switching and I'm sharing sir screen my screen because my topic is very lengthy. I hope.
Sure.
I will finish up in a time.
You take your time. Now, whole screen, whole time is yours, please.
Sir.
Hear yours.
Thank you, sir.
Can you share it?
Yes, sir.
Very good. Full bill, hello.
Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, it's fine now. Yeah, good.
Sir, today's PRP and its variant, I will be talking about PRP first, how it is to be made. I will not be covering the physiological part of this, physiochemistry of this. I will be more focusing on the clinical aspect of PRP. Along with PRP, I would like to show you PRF. Platelet-rich fibrin. Along with this, I would like to show you the platelet-rich fibrin matrix. And lastly, the biofiller. So this PRP, this includes, my talk will be focusing on 4 topics. One is the PRP itself, then PRF, then PRFM, and finally the biofiller. What is a platelet-rich plasma? It's, as the name suggests, the platelets are concentrated into a small volume of plasma. Its effective concentration of multiple fundamental growth factors, and these growth factors are pivotal in modulation of tissue repair and regeneration. So I will be leaving the enzymatic, what the growth factors are there and how they act. So I will be directly coming to how to make PRP. So PRP is basically when you take a blood and if it is not coagulated and it is centrifuged at a very high speed, then this blood will be separated into 3 parts. So one is the lowermost, the black one, and the uppermost is the yellowish, the plasma, and you can see a whitish layer is there that is in between the yellow and black, and this is a buffy coat, and PRP is basically a buffy coat plus few ml of the plasma which is just above the buffy coat. The buffy coat is basically made of the platelets, mainly the platelets. So this is what we are going to separate from the blood. So after centrifugation, you will see this blood is, it's like this. The lowermost part portion, RBC, and then uppermost portion is plasma, and buffy coat is in a concave way. And just above the buffy coat, we have to take 1/3 of the plasma just above the buffy coat, and remaining 2/3, the uppermost layer of the plasma, we have to discard. So this is basically how you make the PRP. This depends on the concentration of effective concentration of platelets in the plasma. So you can do by, there are different ways. One is a double spin method and a single spin. So I will be showing you the double spin method because this method is basically easy to do. though if you are having the number of PRP, say I'm doing at my this college, I usually do around 30 to 40 PRP per session, per session. So we are full of PRP this patient. So in this case, we have to take this two step. Otherwise, the one step, if you are doing for the one patient or two patient, then one step PRP is good enough. Okay? This is the ACD vial I have shown you. Should I go back? This ACD vial, acid citrate, the vial is, ACD is around 1.5 ml and you take 8.5 ml of blood and then centrifuge it in a in a centrifugal machine made by Rami. You can have any kind of machine, but you have to centrifuge for this is for 1200 RPM for 8 minutes. This is soft spin. This is known as soft spin. So this is how the machine looks like from inside. You have to balance the tubes. If you are doing one tube, then you have to keep a balance. And after soft spin, that is 1200 RPM for 8 minutes, how the blood looks like. As I had mentioned to you in a previous slide, that this is divided into three parts. You can see clearly that two parts are very clear, very distinct. The lowermost is the RBCs and the upper one is a plasma. I will show you the buffy coat also in this. This I am showing you a pipette. And pipette is attached with a disposable tips. This is a 1 ml pipette, 100 micro ml, 100 microliters, 1000 microliters. So it's a 1 ml pipette, and this is a tip is gently introduced into the plasma, the uppermost layer. Don't go deep, just from top you have to go. Now you separate this into another vial if you are making a two step. So I will be concentrating two step first. So you take out whole this plasma and be careful during the plasma, taking the plasma. Your hand should not shake, both the hands. You fix your hand at one point and then take very gently this whole plasma. This is a very, very effective method. And in this method, you can make an effective concentration of PRP that is at least five times of the baseline. So you drop it, you take out all this plasma, and now the very crucial step is there. Be very gentle, very gentle. And don't move the tip inside the fluid. Just you should be on the surface of it and just take it very gently, release the pressure very slowly. Now and be careful at this point. This is a very delicate time. See, there's some membranous. Can you see this? Some membrane-like thing is coming. This is a buffy coat, nothing else. If you are able to see this, there's the between the tip of pipette and the fluid, this is something is coming like a membrane. This is a buffy coat. Along with the buffy coat, you will have the some RBC will come definitely, because this is a manual method. So you cannot avoid taking the RBC, but don't worry about the RBC. They are not going to affect this, the results of PRP. Be gentle here. They see this membrane like thing is there. Be gentle. This is the point. You have to take out all the buffy coat. Now you can see all creamy layer has been taken into the next vial. So now we are ready for the second spin. Second spin is a hard spin, and that spin is done at 2400 RPM and it is for 4 minutes. So after the second spin, again, You are going to keep your this first spin plus balance it. Now I'm with the smaller tubes. So now balancing is a very important. If you don't balance, then your whole machine will be having some problem. So again, fixing this, after this fast spin, now our PRP is ready. If you want to make a biofiller along with the PRP, I'll show that biofiller later on, but if you want to make a biofiller out of it, then you take out two-third of the upper portion and keep in a separate tube. Otherwise, if you are doing only PRP, then just discard this upper two-third of the plasma. The lower one-third is our PRP. This is, again, you have to do it very carefully because your whole plasma, this platelets, can you see some whitish color in them at the base of this this tube? It was shown in a previous one, but yes. Now, after making your PRP, you have to get done your counts, what you had actually made. This I will stress because most of the time, whenever you are making, it's a concentration is low. Now, after this, by taking all aseptic precautions, you have to, this is, I'm showing you live video of injection of PRP, take into BD syringe, and gently, intradermally, it is to be applied. You can see this fine, well, this is nothing for the dermatologist. They are very used to this intralesional triamcinolone injection, so there's nothing new about this, but the area is around in a 1 centimeter, at least one injection should be given, and in 1 inch, square inch, 4 injections are to be given, at least. This is the minimum requirement, and this is a case of alopecia areata. You can see this is being injected, and this is this may cause some pain, so you might need to give some block anesthesia, which I'm not giving, but I'm using the vibrator to counter the pain. So I hope this made you understand how a PRP is done with the help of double spin method. Now coming to, should I tell you the single spin? In single spin method, you go for a single fast spin, 2400 for 8 minutes, and then take out the two-third of the plasma, and remaining one-third of plasma is preserved as a PRP. This is nothing to do, but this can be done very rapidly, and it's a very, it can also give the same concentration, but depending upon if you are having a few number of cases, then go for the first single spin. If you are having a large number of cases, then go for the double spin. Now, indications in dermatology. Wide range of indications are there. This has been tried extensively in androgenic alopecia, and many studies have shown a very good result. My study also shows acne scar, contour defect, skin rejuvenation in alopecia areata, melasma, periorbital melanosis, stria, albicantes, gravidorum, whatever the stria is there. And it's very effective in wound ulcers also, and vitiligo. And the list is now, so many indications are there that when you see this Google, you will find a lot more indications of this PRP. This is the number of patients. This in androgenic alopecia, PRP is injected in androgen-related areas of the scalp. The sessions are performed at an interval of 21 days, at least. Or it may be at from 3 to 6 weeks. But preferably, one should do at 21 days. For each patient, 6 such sittings are to be done with a booster session planned at 6 months from onset of therapy. Photographs and dermoscopy, you have to keep record. And this is what the change. The patient after 6 sittings of PRP. You can see the number of hairs. You can see the texture of hair. You can see what an improvement patient had. Again, texture, thickness, and density. And this was a patient of a hair transplant, which I had given along with the hair. PRP is used, as you know, nowadays it is adjuvant. And most of the hair transplant surgeons, they do it as an adjuvant therapy. And I'm also using this. It's see the results. Alopecia, androgenic alopecia, really wonderful. You can see here in this patient, see the first and after 6 weeks. Again, in this case, basically PRP will give you result when the PRP is actually PRP. If it is not a PRP, you just made your PRP, whatever the way I had mentioned you, maybe it's some different way. But if you are not counting your PRP, then if you are not going for the cell count of the PRP, whatever you had made, then it is of no use. Because most of the time, the PRP which we made is usually having the concentration even lower than the basic. So I will recommend, if you want a result, go for the count. Check your what you had made. And most of the time it is PPP. I can bet you. Even I had tried so many this kits of PRP, and they are also of no use according to me. I'll tell you later on. See the results. Beautiful results in alopecia, androgenic alopecia. I got number of patients. I am doing in a department for more than 6 years PRP. And must have done more than 2,000 patients so far. Now, because of the lockdown, it has been stopped in our department. Otherwise, we are routinely doing, and every session on my OPD days, 3 days in a week, and every session we used to have 30 to 40 patients per sitting, per day. There are a lot of problems, but selection of patient is very important. If patient is completely bald, then don't go for the injections. If Hamilton type 6, 7, 8, it's not indicated. It's better to have type 3, 4, 5. Up to 5, you will get a very good result. Age, though, I tried even in a 60 years old patient, but lower the age, better will be the results and less will be the sittings. Site for the injection is again a victory, because wherever, if you see the scalp, if you don't see anything other than the shiny skin, then don't go for the PRP. PRP should work, at least should have a villous kind of hair or some dots with blackening, which indicating that it's a hair was there, some black effects. You must have seen the bald scalp, shining scalp. Don't go for that side. It will be not effective. At least you should have a thin hair, maybe the villous hair, maybe the terminal dots are there. If they are there, then go for PRP and you will get the results. It has been tried in so many conditions. And I also tried in so many conditions and found this is very effective in melasma. It is effective, but it is more effective in periorbital melanosis. I'll show you my results. Injections are administered into papillary dermis, 1.5 to 2 mm deep. PRP is injected into the dermis of the affected area of the face at each session, 15 days interval. At the end of 4 to 5 session of PRP in a melasma, there is a reduction is there. Of course, the reduction in a epidermal hyperpigmentation, I had not observed it, this dermal hyperpigmentation, and is supposed to rebound. So rebound is a natural phenomenon. Everything, whatever you are doing, going against the age or against the nature, then is going to bound, because we in the dermatologists face so many conditions, especially talking of aesthetic. So rebound or recurrence, say I'd given this grown the hair in an androgenic alopecia, they are going to, one day they are going to lost. So in this patient, you can see the melasma, there's a great reduction. And now coming to in periorbital melanosis, you see this. I found this is the only effective therapy for POL. You see pre and post, along with not only go for the color, see the texture of skin, see the wrinkles, which were present in the first photograph. You compare in a second photograph. You see the drastic changes. The PRP is not only giving the taking the color of the hyperpigmentation, but also rejuvenating the skin. This is a wonderful photograph, and patient is very happy. doctor, you had not only removed this hyperpigmentation, you also given me an excellent young looking skin. This is after 3 sitting. Wonderful results of this, even in this patient also, you can see. Comparable, it's very effective. And what I want to stress is in this patient is the arrow is there. You can see there's a fold of in a upper eyelid. Can you make out? And that has gone in a second picture. This is the effect of PRP. PRP, to me, it's a wonderful result. It gives wonderful results. It's a wonderful tool in our dermatologist's hand. Vitiligo, my favorite topic and my favorite disease. And I also tried in this patient, and this paper has been also published. My paper, a few papers have been published in PRP. Vitiligo is also one of them. And here again, we have to give intradermal injections. So in PRP, into the vitiligo patches every 2 weekly, and sitting depending upon the pigmentation. So you can go on doing, but the thing is, you can see the changes are there in arrow is indicated here. But the point here is even this acral pigment. This is, I'm talking of acral pigmentation, which is very difficult to have pigment. And it is effective, but you have to keep on doing it. This is after 10 sittings. So you need a lot of patience, and not only the patience. Basically, you need a lot of blood to be withdrawn. So effectively, if you have having a few patches, very small patches, then it is it's a very good technique. You can see the changes, even in this patient also. These are the ideal patient. In this patient, we tried only to the indicated site because otherwise the area was so extensive, it was not suitable for the patient also. But the point in this is indication in a vitiligo is only when it is stable. Otherwise, in unstable vitiligo, please don't go for PRP. And don't go for the PRP in when an extensive vitiligo is there. Smaller patches, you can give good results. See this excellent results after 10 sittings. There are so many cases are there. In this is a case of vitiligo with alopecia areata. Both disease at the same site and both are improving. It's effective in alopecia areata as well as in a vitiligo. And you can see that the hairs are coming out and the vitiliginous hairs turn into the normal looking pigmented skin. PRP in a vitiligo is a good alternative for the lesions which do not respond to medical treatment and a cheaper, safer, non-invasive mode of therapy for the patients not willing for the surgical treatment. But limitations are limitations. It's not suitable for the larger lesions. I'll not go to the details of this. Even a striadistancy, it can be used as a filler. Even PRF can be tried in a striadistancy. Even PR biofiller can be tried, and PRP itself can be tried. Sittings are needed more. And again, here is the same problem as we faced in a vitiligo, where stria are usually extensive. But a patient, if having some visible stria on the area where he want to get it done, then we can go for the PRP. And you can see the results of this. You can see in again. See, the results are no doubt very good. In this is an initial patient. We tried this, and you can see this stria has disappeared, almost disappeared. Side effects are minimal, mild swelling, bruising, redness, and some tingling sensation is there. Some burning type of sensations will be there for a few minutes. And the mild swelling may be there. Swelling, bruising may be there for 12 to 24 hours. Anytime the skin is punctured, the infection, as we know, is a theoretical risk. But infections are rare complications with PRP. I will tell you later on why they are very rare. Limitation, the whole large area we have to cover, so it's not a good way to treat this. So PRP post procedure care, patient can resume normal daily activity just after a few hours. This is and the important in this is no anti-inflammatory to be used for 4 weeks. Now, at least for a week, at least patient should avoid this, because whatever the cascade we had started by inflammation, that will be stopped if we use anti-inflammatory, including, I will say, including the steroid. The most potent anti-inflammatory tool in our hand is the steroids, and don't even go for the topical steroid as well. Moisturizers can be used frequently, and ice can be applied over tender areas. Safety, as we all aware that this is an autologous preparation, PRP is devoid of any serious side effects apart from the local injection site reaction like pain and secondary infection. And pain you can counteract with the help of a local anesthesia, block anesthesia. If you are using it on a whole PRP, a good session of PRP may require a block anesthesia of the scalp. You can use the vibrators, you can use the ethyl chloride spray, and you can simply use the ice cubes, ice packs on the scalp and just remove the ice cap and give an injection. This is a very good method also. Almost no downtime is there, no need for the hospitalization. There are few contraindications, abnormal platelet functions, severe metabolic systemic disorders, infections, critical thrombocytopenia, autoimmune disease, chronic liver, and this you have to take care of the infections. In my opinion, and as you are getting this, this is a potential role of PRP in dermatology and aesthetic medicine is unlimited. Realization of its true potential may eventually lead to a superior array of therapies in a various aesthetic challenge in near future, and I'm showing you the one or few of these techniques. Though double-blind trial is very few. Randomized placebo-controlled trials are very few. Large sample size to be done for the greater evidence. There are so many myths about that I want to talk about. Method of injection, intrafollicular versus intradermal. So it's very difficult to find out where you are going. Intradermal is, in my opinion, when I started using PRP, the pictures of giving injection of PRP in the literature were in a perpendicular way. So, and they were saying that this is how the intrafollicular you have to inject. But even simple intradermal injection, what we are using, this is very good. It gives very good result. And one more hype is there, the cooling chamber centrifugal machine, whether temperature control is required or not. In my opinion, this process takes around 12 minutes. And in 12 minutes, there will be no such a drastic increase in temperature. I had seen so many times that going to affect your PRP, not at all. And I never use the cooling chambers centrifugal machine. I use the ordinary one. Even one can use this the non-digital one that is having the five pockets, the five tube centrifugal machine by the only one company is there, I think. I don't know other if the other companies are there, but that is very cheap and it costs around 4,000 to 5,000. And now this is a burning issue, the PRP kits. Do expensive kits produce better results? I will say no, not at all. The best method is the manual one. I had tried so many PRP kits, and when I go for the concentration of platelets in these so-called advantageous kits, I found the concentration was even very, very less than what the basic concentration of platelets was there. So don't go for this. This is a simple technique, manual technique. It takes around 15 minutes for one sample. 8 minutes of soft and 4 minutes of that fast spin and hard spin, and 12 minutes and 3 minutes for the taking in and out and all everything. This 15 minutes, and 15 minutes you can give the very good result by making your own PRP. And of course, for the private practitioner, this will increase the profit level of profit for them also. So there is no harm, and this not at all harm. This is the best wise advisable thing for them. And I now coming to the what is the ideal interval between sittings for the best results? There is no such formulation has been done so far, but literature says in a androgenic alopecia it's between 3 to 6 weeks. In a remaining most of the condition, it is around 2 weeks. And role of activator, yes, this is again a point, a very very important point. And I don't believe that it is necessary in a manual method of PRP. I don't feel there is no need of activator to be put in the PRP, because what I feel is the platelets which are there, they are the basically the pockets of the growth factors. And when the every pocket of the growth factor is these pockets of the growth factors are lined by a membrane that is going to rupture within a few hours when injected into the extracellular. So there is no need. Once they are ruptured, the membrane is ruptured, this growth factors, they are going to be dispersed in the surrounding tissue. And why to break the membrane early? What is the need? Basically, if you are breaking the platelets membrane early, then there are chances that while injecting, you are losing some of the growth factors, because they are also having a very very less half-life. So, and the post-PRP count must be, and it should be there, and this is the only correct approach. You have to assess and you have to do your best results. I'll not take, because I have 3 more presentations, so I will not go in-depth. Sir, And as the, I'll just, antibiotics are not required. I will not go into detail. Ideal interval, I told you, distant effect of PRP. This we have observed in some patients of androgenic alopecia. And while injecting the PRP at a scalp, we got a distance effect on the shining of skin and improvement in melasma, improvement in POH. So this is what we observed, but it has not been reported, and even not reported by us also. And I don't know the mechanism, how it happened. I don't know, but it happened. One should take care of this. Cooling chamber, I already talked about PRP kits. I talked about activators. Yes, I did everything. And we must have this post PRP counts. PRP, I also talked about this difference between topical and minoxidil should be stopped before 6 months. And one more thing I want to say you is, not only this is effective in androgenic alopecia for regrowth, even this is effective for the hair fall treatment also. So I am also using it, and in hair fall treatment we have to use every 15 days, and a whole of the scalp including is to be treated, and it's very effective. In 2 or 3 sittings there will be drastic change. These are the counts when we make, then we go for the cell counts. This is the highlighted 46 lakhs. And here the platelets 56 lakhs. Even we got the count very high up to 80 lakhs, but more than 80 lakhs. But if you are having this kind of count, then you can have more plasma of the patient and dilute it with the help of problems there we have faced. And I almost talk each and everything. This is all about the basic PRP. Now I will be shifting to, I will be changing and sharing the skin, because this is a very big topic. And now I will be talking about, sir, is it okay listening? Now I will be talking about PRFM.
Keep it up.
Sir, PRFM. Now I am coming to the PRFM. सर आ रहा है ऑटोलोगस पीआरएफएम इन नॉन एलिगेंस सर कैन यू सी
आ रहा है आ रहा है
वेरी गुड वेरी गुड
सर But the non-healing ulcers are basically they are the spontaneous or traumatic lesions, typically anywhere, and are unresponsive to initial therapy, or they persist despite of appropriate care and do not proceed towards healing in a definite time period with an underlying etiology that may be related to some systemic disease or maybe the local disease. There are many types of non-healing ulcers that may include venous, arterial, diabetic, the surgical aspect, as you all know. And despite of treatment, many chronic ulcers fail to heal or persist for months or years together. Or even they recur after healing, requiring additional. Not covering the theoretical aspect. And show how it is being made. So this is how what we are withdraw the blood, take it in a test tube. Now this time the ACD is not required. Here we don't want to use ACD. Okay, you take in a normal vial. This is how we are taking after taking all aseptic precautions and everything. This is procedure is being done in our MOT, and we are withdrawing the blood of the patient. This is again an autologous. Let's go away. सॉरी थोड़ा सा गड़बड़ हो रहा लग रहा है बीच में सेंटर में यस नाउ आफ्टर विड्रॉइंग द ब्लड इन अ नॉन एसीडी वायल दिस आर द प्लेन वायल यू टेक अ 3 to 5 ml ऑफ द ब्लड एंड सेंट्रीफ्यूज एट अ वेरी हाई स्पीड 3000 RPM फॉर 10 मिनट्स एंड आफ्टर 10 मिनट्स टेक इट आउट एंड नाउ विद द हेल्प ऑफ फोर्सेप्स यू टेक आउट jelly like the topmost layer. This is platelet rich fibrin matrix. You have to discard this remaining, and now you just gently press it, and this your membrane is now ready. And this now you can apply your non-healing ulcers. This is a really wonderful treatment, I'll say. I had treated the non-healing ulcer up to years together, maybe 3-4 years long. Even with the sinuses, with the long cavities, long tract going deep down, seen the sacral bone, seen the femoral head, but even despite all this, this gives a very good result. And this procedure is repeated every week. Up to a maximum of maybe 5 sittings, or maybe you can continue the sittings till the patient heals. At the beginning, we have to assess whether it's effective or not. This is theoretical aspect, the length and width into this is how you have to do in eclipse and all this type of ulcer. These are the changes which we had done at thesis of my student. And this has been published in so many journals, 2-3 articles of this PRFM. And in most of the time, you can see the difference, the p-value difference. So this is, I'll show you in pictures. Now this, you can see this after 12 weeks follow. See the results. Wonderful result in this, again. Even in the cases of leprosy, the trophic ulcer, foul smelling ulcer, make the ulcer, debride it and apply this PRFM. Wonderful results are there. Mostly it may take around 12 weeks or even more than that. But wherever you had tried anything, other than PRFM, all the things, and there is no response to this or your treatment, then think of PRFM. This is a very useful tool and it's having very good results. Now, this is the second topic. I finished. Now I'm coming to the PRF. This is platelet-rich fibrin. The difference between this and biofiller is there are differences, and this was this PRF was used long ago by this dentist. Basically, they started using in oromaxillofacial and implant surgery in a century ago, maybe. And this wonder material at that time they called it wonder material. It was effective in regeneration. It was effective having the regenerative potential, and this is even good for the dermatologist also. And you will find that this is a very good method for giving a good aesthetic look to the patient. Blood collection as we did in a glass test tube without anticoagulant. This is the important point. It should be without anticoagulant and the table centrifugal machine. Method of preparation, blood samples are obtained without an anticoagulant in a 10 ml glass or glass coated plastic tube. Immediately centrifuge at 3000 RPM, not for 10 minutes. If you are making it for 10 minutes, then it's going to convert into gel. I'm sorry for the some mistake here, but it should be centrifuged for 3 to 5 minutes only. So then only the liquid part you can take out. Otherwise, in 10 minutes, whole gel, just now I had shown you PRFM, how this matrix is formed in 10 minutes. But in 3 to 5 minutes, it will be a liquid and full of the growth factors and the fibrin and everything is there. As I told you, this 3 layers will be obtained after centrifugation. Red blood cells, bottom, poor platelet, poor plasma at the top, and a fibrin clot formed. And just as the clot is formed in 10 minutes, we have to centrifuge for 3 to 5 minutes only. So the fibrin will be concentrated there at the middle layer. The topmost is a PPP, platelet poor plasma, and the lowermost is the RBCs, and the in between the platelets with the fibrin and all most of the growth factors. Full of the, what is the difference between this PRP and this PRF is the growth factors which are being circulated in a blood. They are also taken in this PRF. While in PRFM, they are, most of them are being destroyed. And fibrin, of course. I'll show how to make it. This is the taking of the blood and transferring. Here you have to take care, because as soon as blood is out from the body, the cascade of coagulation starts. So here you must be very fast. Don't wait for anything. Everything should be ready beforehand. There is no downtime. You have to do it immediately. So at 3000 RPM, take out this in a 3 to 5 minutes and take into this. You can see the 3 layers. You depending on the site, you have to take it in injection syringe and inject it. This is basically Solochi. This is a shrunken eye. You have to do it immediately. Everything, patient should lie down, area prepared, everything prepared. You in a running mode you have to do. Otherwise, this what you have taken is will be coagulating in a 1 minute only. So everything must be very quick, and this gives very good results. and wherever the large area is required, even in acne scar also, this is very good. You can see pre and post. See this wrinkles, the large wrinkles in this patient. See the depth of these wrinkles, how they have become very light, very superficial. In acne scars, excellent improvement. Even this PRF is a very good. I tried in this patient on one side only, and you can see the eyebrows. The lifting of eyebrow is because of this PRF. And this I did in a second sitting, and patient was looking so young. And the results, see this again. This old man, 80-year-old man, he came to my clinic and told doctor, I want to become young. You can you remove my this wrinkles, these lines? Can you reduce the depth of my this nasolabial fold and this infralabial, all this? I told, yes, I can do, but you have to expend at least 50 to 1 lakh. He said, doctor, I'm going. I don't fall. I said, ki Baba ji, aapki umar ko salam hai aur main aapko free karunga. And then I found out things and did the PRFM to this patient. And you can see this infraorbital, this lining. After one sitting only, can you see this? And here you can see the injection site is there. And patient was so happy that doctor, you at least you need what patient want to get done and do that. Patient will be very happy. See the even this periorbital melanoma, it's very good. And with this is basically a post and this is pre. You can see the wrinkles and the color difference. The photograph is not the good quality, but here in this patient, this is a post photograph. Upper one is the post photograph. And the lower one is a pre-photograph, and see the wrinkles here, and now in a post, you see the difference, and see the shining skin, which she got it. And see the blem, the texture of her skin. This is what a beautiful she looked. And she was so happy. And this, what you can do with her own blood. Again, this is again here. It basically, this was done in my mobile. So layout is there. So the first picture I select is usually on the upper, and the last picture taken is selected first. So that is how this the difference is there. But you can see the hollow, the color, the wrinkles. See this side especially. See the wonderful effect. Even in one sitting, you can see this lady have got this wrinkles by one sitting, the out of three, only two, and the face becomes you can see the difference of the melasma also. That also improved. Just nearby melasma, you can see that is there and is improved in the second picture. And see the shrunken eyes as well. In this patient, see this and this. This is also, there's a lot of improvement. Periorbital melanosis, again, it gives very good results. If the, especially when the periorbital melanosis, along with the shrunken eyes or some eyes are going, having some defect or contour defect also, then you better to use PRF, not the PRP. This is, again, the periorbital melanosis. This is a young patient and having so many wrinkles at this age, and now you can see. Upar niche hai, pre is niche and post is upar. So you can make out the difference in the periorbital. And see the texture, the change in the color, not only color, but texture and the wrinkles around. Can you point out? Can you figure it out? My photographs are very clear. I think you must be appreciating. You can appreciate the change which I want to show you. Even the fine wrinkles are being photographed, and you can see the difference in these photographs. Again, the same. This gives a wonderful results. This is Everything is PRP is to me, PRP is a very useful tool. Even I had tried in so many other conditions also. This is a simple open access technique, minimized autologous blood manipulation, because you are not needing some ACD also. Even the direct blood and then centrifuging delivers autologous multiple growth factors, safe without disease transmission, has low cost. But the problem with this is you have to be very quick on the toes. Then only you can inject. Otherwise, the whole PRF will be deposited, will be coagulated in a syringe itself. There are so many applications of this. Nasal level fold, facial volumizer, superficial rhytidid, acne scar, rhinoplasty, facial aesthetic. Rhinoplasty is not our domain though. Facial aesthetic, autologous fat transfer. In effect of this, there are so many indications of this. In conclusion, the PRF belongs to new generation of platelet concentrate. It is in the first place efibrin technology. So now last 5 minutes are left and I am ready for my last biofiller, which recently I had given in a e-derma call. It is day before yesterday. Biofiller, yes. Can you see my biofiller, slides?
Oh, yes.
Is it visible, sir?
We can see. Please go ahead.
Sir, biofiller plasma gel or biofiller has been used in dermatology and aesthetics over many years. And our platelet poor plasma is basically a primary source of plasma gel. And it is basically heat denaturation of platelet poor plasma or clot activation with activators, as suggested by few authors. The process of heat denaturation to obtain plasma gel is effectively utilized in our center. I'll show you the video. I will not go to the history and everything. I will be more precise on the practical tips. Basically, this is how the denaturation of biofiller, how the biofiller concept came. You can see the liquid portion of protein. Anyway, and slowly coagulating into whitish cream. So procedure is in, we have to take care of all informed consent, photograph, investigation, topical anesthesia, everything. Aspirate the 8.5 ml blood into ACD vial. Again, the ACD vial is coming here. Centrifuge at 1200 RPM for 8 minutes. Collect the supernatant platelet poor plasma. So here is some point you have to note. If you are making only biofiller, then after step three, the centrifuge at 1200 RPM for 8 minutes and take out all the plasma, whatever is there. And if you are making simultaneous PRP as well as biofiller in one patient in one go, that also is possible. So in that PRP section, I told you that you have to take the upper two-third of the plasma in a separate vial and take lower one-third of plasma with a buffy coat in a separate vial. So the lower portion, lower one-third portion of the plasma with a buffy coat is your PRP, and the upper two-third of the plasma that is there in a separate tube, you proceed for the biofiller, making a biofiller. It is basically heat at 90 to 100 degrees Celsius for 1 minute till the plasma gel is become semi-solid. Cool it under cold water for a minute and the gel is obtained and it is injected at target site. That's it. This machine, I told you how to take it. These are some procedural advice, the same as we are doing in PRP and everything. This is how the video is. I made it short. Just take out blood, centrifugation, 1200 at for 8 minutes. Now take out the This is PPP, and now PPE is boiled, and then heat boiled for a minute, and then make it cold for a minute, and then this is how it looks like. This is a gel like. You can see this, how it is being. It's a very clear fluid. See, this is how it is being injected. In an acne scar, deep scar, the linear scar, you can fill with this. The procedure is very simple. You have to select the depth. In indications for facial lines, lip enhancement, facial deformities, deep red scar, breast and buttock augmentation, very large amount. Periocular melanosis, shrunken eyes, dermatological disease like angular cheilitis, scleroderma. I don't know why they are, how they are effective, but I never used, but these are the mentioned in the literature. This is how it looks like. See. Yes. Again, you have to go in a right plane and then make it at least 10 to 20% extra. Make it extra on the surface. See that, this is wonderfully shrunken eyes. You can see this change and the lines, and here also you can see the number of wrinkles here. Shrunken eyes, number of wrinkles has reduced, and along with this upper eyelid. See also upper eyelid and lower eyelid, both pre and post. See the difference. Biofillers are also effective in acne scar. This periorbital melanosis with shrunken eye, you can see the change. You can see this. This is how you can do wonders with a patient's own blood. This again. Thank you for patient listening. And I think, sir, I made it in 1 hour exactly. Just a minute.
No, listen. Thank you very much. And it is not a question of 1 hour. You could have even taken it, because in this hour meeting, probably time is, if you have got material, there is nobody to disturb you for that purpose. And that is a very...
Sir, but charo cheez bata di aur main cheeze sab bata di, sir.
Main to usme ek hi baat, ek hi comment karunga main.
Sir.
मैं तो उसमें एक ही कमेंट करूंगा कि जो एक एक बात तो होती है कि साला आदमी के हाथ में अगर शफा होने तो शफा से जो है वो वाकई में काम करता है. एंड यू हैव गॉट दैट, वो आपके हाथ में शफा है.
सर एक इंटरप्ट करूं?
हाँ
सर. हाँ. ये शफा मेरी नहीं है, आप लोगों की दीवी है. It's not mine, sir. आप लोग गुरुजन बैठे हैं, आप लोगों ने दी है.
नहीं 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 नहीं. You have done a wonderful job. You have done a wonderful work and a very brilliant this wonderful presentation. In fact, we all know PRP and its variants and all these things, but the way in which you are working and your results probably unmatchable. Very good, very nice, and I compliment you for all these things. Dr. Lalit, is there anything in the chat box or anything else would you like to comment? Anybody else wants to comment?
There are a couple of questions in the chat box, sir.
Yes, please.
First of all, I must compliment Dilip for a wonderful and very useful talk for the residents and all of us. I think this is the best example how you can recycle things up. True. So with the whole blood, you can do anything what you want. Biofillers and everything, so it was excellent. It is a good use of the techniques, and a very simple technique and very useful one. So wonderfully done, Dilip. I must congratulate.
Thank you, sir.
And so far as the questions are concerned, in the chat box, somebody is interested to know about how many days should we keep the dressings intact after PRF. Clot application. So this is one.
Very good question, sir. Very good question. You apply PRF FM dressing and leave it for 7 days. Whenever the patient is coming for the next dressing, at that time you have to remove it.
The other question is, can we use incubator for preparation of PPP biofiller?
Yes, of course, one can have the incubators, one can have the laminar flow and everything, depending upon what the facility you have. But I emphasized on is, anyone can make these things with a simple that is centrifugal machine costing 3,000 to 5,000 only. The emphasis is, this is the only minimum requirement. Above this, you can have whatever you can.
True.
Sir wanted to say, but sir, you are muted by yourself.
What is your comment about the refrigerated centrifuge? Do you use it or how long?
सर मैं बिल्कुल नहीं यूज करते, हम तो सिंपल मशीन यूज करते हैं. ये सारे मार्केट गेम है सर.
सिंपल मशीन, नो रेफ्रिजरेटेड.
सेम यस,
दिस रेमी फेलो, दे आर डूइंग गुड जॉब
सर.
प्लीज एक्सप्लेन अबाउट मिनोक्सिडिल एंड पीआरपी यूजेस. दिस इज अनदर क्वेश्चन.
मिनोक्सिडिल अलोंग विद पीआरपी, आई पब्लिश द पेपर ऑफ दिस. And PRP and minoxidil both goes in hand. They are adjuvant to each other. PRP you can stop after 6 months, and minoxidil you have to continue. You will have a better results by combining both these.
As you mentioned, to stop minoxidil 6 weeks before.
Yes, if patient is not happy with the minoxidil, then you are not supposed to start just after stopping the minoxidil. If patient is not happy with the minoxidil, you ask him that stop your minoxidil previous, and then because the fall is there after stopping minoxidil, so a patient will have the natural coats of the hairs, because if you are starting immediately after stopping minoxidil, then patient will say, doctor, my hairs are falling and your PRP is not effective. But it is जबकि ये हो किस लिए रहा, बिकॉज ऑफ स्टॉपिंग ऑफ मिनोक्सिडिल. सो वी हैव टू रेस्टलाइज द थिंग्स.
शुड वी पुट एन इनक्यूबेटर सेटिंग्स एट 100 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड? Somebody is asking.
इनक्यूबेटर फॉर व्हाट?
शुड वी पुट इनक्यूबेटर सेटिंग्स एट 100 डिग्री सेंटीग्रेड?
फॉर व्हाट? फॉर व्हाट? आई मेड 3-4 टेक्निक्स वेयर ही वांट टू यूज इनक्यूबेटर एट 100 डिग्री. आई थिंक दिस क्वेश्चन इज फॉर द बायोफिलर. So 100 is enough. Don't go above 100. 90 to 100 is good enough, and 1 minute is a time, minimum time, maximum time.
I think that's it from the chat box.
Sir. Thank you, sir.
Wonderful, wonderful presentation once again. And thank you very much, Dilip. Thanks a lot.
Sir, thank you. Thank you, you all. And it was my pleasure, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
Else, if no, there's no question, then we say good night to everyone.
Good night, everyone.
Good night. Good night.